Scandinavia, Scotland, Iceland and Greenland. This one's Icelandic by descent. 5 years old, times five, is 25 in species terms. No, that noisy means he's just being very, very chatty. He's had a little shake just now, and he's had his hood on for 15 minutes too, before we started. I've had the peregrine falcon, because they were trying to start 15 minutes early. They're revving up their engines. Pop the hood on, and they calm right down. It's because they can see 80 different moving events per colours too, like you and me, but they see ultraviolet on top, that's four colours. And then they see two images per eye, we see one and one. So they're seeing life in much more clarity and speed than we are. This is why they're highly strung. Of course, if you're travelling at 200, it's to chase it. And of course, it burns him out, it gets rid of energy, it exercises, hones all his hunting skills, which is turning, twisting, diving, stooping, grabbing, the things in the air. So he's honing all his, this is like private practice for him, if you like. And you can keep trying to get a picture, you probably won't, but I'll bring him closer. Let's go this way, this way. And then another one here, just over your heads. So this is how we've been training for 4,000 years, with this lure, keeping them fit, keeping them sharp. And then we drop it on the floor when they've used a bit of fuel, and they'll parachute in for it, because I was getting dizzy there. There you go. I'm going to keep doing this sleep as a swap. There we go. And you can take that on that pause there and eat it in front of everybody if you like. There you go. So there's 60 species of falcon on the planet. In the UK, we've only got 5 species of falcon, but there's 60 worldwide. And the smallest falcon in the world they need. Therefore, it restricts what birds they can catch in that arc. But if they're coming down in the vertical stoop, then they can take most things out, smaller or bigger. Anyway, I'm going to give him some more exercise once he's finished eating that. That should slow him down a little bit. And he could live for 20 years, remember. In the wild, he wouldn't be here. If it was left to nature's law of averages, they'd all be dead down there. And they know that too. Of course, you can't go too high because that wall's in the way. In the tundra, there's no walls. It's just open spaces. But I'll just keep bringing him down here. So I can tie him out. I'm going to walk a bit further forward to help him with his exit strategies. I'll go that way this time. So he can hear twice as sharp as a human. He's got five. One more pass this way. If I'm quick enough, I can get a piece of my bag there. Oh. Had to be quick though. Now, he's gone past me. He's just gone past me. And then I put my hand in the bag, got a piece. But by the time I'd done that, he'd gone out and turned around and come back. Now, our eyesight is so slow, so there's been wars prevented throughout history with gifts and things. That's how important they've been in our history, because if you were a member of the Danish royal family at the height of falconry in the medieval years, you were very popular because you could procure these from Iceland, where you had connections, and you could make them gifts to all the royal households of Europe. And of course, to have one of these, you were very special. I'll drop that there. Mary, Queen of Scots, could only afford one. She was Scotland's most. The only thing is, this has got a cat's leg, but it's good to wind cat horns up with. Which is everybody in the UK, everybody has two, nobody ever has one. Anyway, he's eating a rabbit. You can hear him snapping pieces of bone off it. Can you hear that? He's snapping through flesh and bone. He's got a very powerful beak. And at the same time, he's hiding it from other birds of prey. I'll walk down the line as he's eating this, and you can hear him tearing through that there. I'll just pull that bit of fur back there, and then isn't nature wonderful? Unless you're a rabbit. Now, I'm just going to flick his wings with my fingers. Can you hear that? I'll do that again. Very stiff. He can't feel me doing that, of course, because feathers are made of keratin, fingernails, dead matter. Very, very stiff and hard. Now, as he's chomping away there, he's trying to turn around on my fist, turning and turning, trying to hide it all the time, because he knows I want a bit of that back. But I'm going to exchange it for chicken McNugget. all the time he's making it more difficult for me. Remember, when I'm flying them in display like this, I've got to keep them over full, otherwise I'll just go and kill the seagulls. They're on the menu. So in display, you've got to get it just right with their appetite. If I want to go hunting with them, well, I go a little bit later when they've got more of an appetite, and then they'll start chasing their own dinner. But they can have a bit of fun with the lure too. So I'm putting this furniture back on. Is anklets. This is called bullet jesses. I've got to take all this attire off him when he's flying for obvious reasons. Now, I'm going to exchange if I can. I'll just come down here. I'm going to ask him to exchange that rabbit for chicken McNugget. No problem. Of course I didn't just take that off him, did I? Because that's negative. And he would fall out with me very, very quickly. It's very fresh and you could eat this. You probably wouldn't. You'd probably go to McDonald's and eat that crap instead. Anyway, he's going to eat that very, very quickly. I've got more in my bag for him. All the time he's eating, he's stashing it in his crop, on his chest, in his pouch. It's not actually going into his stomach. That'll take 10 minutes before it goes from pouch to stomach. And I'm going to give him another piece there. And I walk back down here. And by the time he's finished that, I can put him away. He should be quite full. So the smallest falcon we have in the UK is called a merlin. And of course, to have a merlin, about 150 years ago, things changed. But before then, to have a merlin, you would be a lady. A lady could have a little falcon called a merlin. You couldn't have one of these unless you're a queen. And to have an eagle, you'd be an emperor. To have a lanner falcon, you'd be an earl. To have the next guy I'm bringing out, Bonsai, an owl, you'd be a wizard. And they pass down wisdom, apparently. Right, he's finished, so I'm going to clean his beak off to show you how gently he is with my fingers. You've got to trust them completely, 100%, with their beak and their feet when they're with you. And otherwise you can't handle them. Can you see that lump on his chest, everybody? He's asking for more too, can you see that? If I give him any more now and ask him to fly tomorrow, he'll say you do it. Because they don't eat every day in the wild, they only eat every second or third day. They're not that good. Even though he's fast and he's got great eyesight, he's nowhere near as successful at catching dinner as the next one I'm going to bring out. And so he's going to store 2 days' worth of food. If he catches a wood pigeon, which weighs 1 pound, he weighs 2.5, he would eat the lot in one sitting. And then his crop would be out there. And then he'd have to make his way to a cliff top or a top of a tree, and he would sit like this for 2 days. But he wouldn't be worried because he's not going to hunt anymore. He's got that there. So the next 2 days are covered. Because they live every day. He's got 5 eggs. And I'm not going to give it him just yet. Fonzie, your turn. Anyway, this guy is 19 years old. It was his birthday a day or two ago. And I know exactly how old they are because they're all domestically bred, so you know where they came from. This guy came from a zoo in the Czech Republic. He came to me 19 years ago. When he came to me, I had lots of hair, a long time ago. And as far as he's concerned, I'm Papa Owl. Because owls you have to hand rear. You don't hand rear the other species, but owls you have to. His body is small, the falcon's body is big to power it through there, two big muscles. This guy just glides. I'm going to glide over your camera, you ready? Well, there's no wind, no weather to worry about really, but everything you can hear from a long distance off is quite quiet in there. So the silent glide is very, very useful. Mice, snakes, worms, frogs, rabbits, other birds of prey. The smallest bird of prey we have in the UK, the little owl, he would eat them. People are panicking when I'm behind him. I was going to go down to the camera, but I'll go here because he's going to get a good shot there. Bonzi? Here we are, they get any night time. And that's when they're feeding babies, every 2 hours. So even the nocturnal ones, i.e. barn owl and tawny owl, are out all day long hunting. Now I've got to go behind that camera down there if I'm quick enough. I've managed it, here we go.
That's a good shot.
I'll keep him off off the hat now, there you go. Let's go back that way, I think. So this guy can hear a mouse. Very often killed by the roadside, heavy traffic. What they do is they fix on the mouse on the other side of the road that they can hear, and then they filter out the traffic noise. Of course, that's to their detriment then, isn't it? They've got no answer for cars. Right. Try and get behind this fella here.
Here we go.
Right. Has he got a worm?
Got
I think
them,
he's
eh?
On the ground with a worm, is he? Yeah. Yeah. He can hear them. 7, so we can do 180. We can move our eyes 40 degrees in the socket. See, he's got no movement because his eyes are tubes. They're not like ours, ball. So they're fixed in there. World that can smell with a sense of smell. That's obviously three of the vulture family.
Hi Lauren, are you? That's a good girl. There, perfect. You okay there? Don't worry if he goes on your arm, he's very, very gentle. No, let's get him back off there.
Okay, round of applause for Lauren, please. This is absolutely true. And then, of course, once it rings, he jumps up. It frightens him every time. And yet he's been doing it for 19 years and it still makes him jump. So he really hasn't learned a lot there. When he's in the... No, Bonsai is going to swallow his dinner very, very quickly.
Oh.
That's it, gone. That's his second chicken. He's going to get another one later. And then we'll put him just down here. And then if he comes anywhere near you, don't worry about it. He's looking for the blue rope that I usually have here, along here. And he kills it every day. He thinks it's a snake. And he's wondering where the hell... 19 years he's been killing it. He can't find it now. I tricked him today. So we'll forget Bonsai for now. But when I finish... And the falcon, peregrine falcon. Peregrinations means wandering. Anyway, and the executioner of old always had a black mask on to try and emulate this guy with his chop. No. He's ready to go, so I'll put a little bit of food there. I put a little transmitter on his ankle. Can you see that? The only advancement in 4,000 years of falconry tells me where he is if he's in a light check. What about that last rose? Did it change? Remember, this is a game he loves to play also. I'm going to bring him in once or twice and give him a few passes. I want him to come down this line where... There we go. I'm trying to try it from there. No, I've got to keep watching all the time. Hey! I'll try to do it from there. And then I'll get my flag again and get another piece just here. Now I'm just going to tie a piece of chicken McNugget on the state's falcons. Himself would pull the stirrups while the falcon had gone on his horse. And come mealtime at night, his lordship would carry out the falconer's meal and deliver it to him. That's how highly thought of the falconer was in the old days. I yearn for the old days. Here we go, camera's ready. Oops. Oh, that's an easy one. Faster than a peregrine falcon. I mean, the way he whipped around that course there was amazing. That's a big last minute change. Anyway, I'm going to give a few more passes here. Down the line here. And he was coming in so I couldn't hear the bell. I went to the falcons above the grouse, about 1,000 feet, and then I sent the dogs in, and the dogs flushed the grouse, and the grouse then has to fly. And if they continue flying, there's a very good chance they'll die. But of course, if they're clever, they just drop back in the heather, and then give this guy one of them. And of course, they're the clever ones because they're going to carry on and live and breed more. The stupid ones who try and beat him get caught. And nature, of course, is very happy for the stupid ones to get caught because they don't want them to produce any more stupid ones if they all get caught. This is the grouse. Now, once he's caught the grouse, of course, he's caught it for himself. But I want it. And what I do is I have trained him to catch this lure and land near me. So when he catches game, he lands near me with it, by habit, force of habit. And then I move in with Chicky McNugget. He's got the grouse, I want the grouse, I walk in with this, he thinks this is my dinner. When he sees it, he thinks he'll eat that as well, because they're very greedy. And in return, he loses his grouse to me. This is what I do. You can hide it from the field. Can you see this? And then I do this, and he can't wait to steal that off my... He's got one there, but he wants this as well. And of course, that's perfect for me, because while he's not watching, I just put the grouse in my bag. And then when he's finished this, he says, I'll get back to my... Where's the grouse gone? It must have flown away. Let's catch another one. Positive reinforcement. Now, in Scotland, we have to... If any falconer wants a peregrine falcon, you've got to have a domestically bred peregrine falcon. That means you've got to have the ones I have, which are bred from disabled parents. So if they're disabled, they can produce offspring. And then you can train them. Now, in many other countries, you can take them from the wild. In America, you get licensed. In fact, we're now giving out licenses in the UK. There were 7 given out last year to take a peregrine.
Oh, sorry. Okay, got it. Okay.
Come on, that can do it before it gets warm.
That's cold.
Do you want a bite?
No.
Sorry, I asked it. I ate chicken at home. Where is he now?
Well, there, that way.
Where is he?
Why do you think he doesn't want to eat
it? It's just not as warm, isn't it?
Swarm.
It's like people. I mean, this guy's very old, he's 30, so he's 95 in eagle years. So his diet isn't what his appetite isn't what it used to be. He's had his breakfast, he's eaten today already, so he's had some. And when he gets into his flight pen, I'm going to start putting him away in 15 minutes.